That was a setting of a very old song called The Gower Wassail. And it's based on that, which nobody knows who wrote it, and nobody knows how old it is. Something you might recognise the some of the words for this. one is written by Maria.
Thank you.
and Tim Bowen, Fool's Echo.
Thank you. Thank you. in about 10-15 minutes with the final performance, which is the premiere of A J Dehany's Sonic Dream Poem, "As Part We Are Together." So don't go anywhere except for up to the bar to get another drink. And see you all in 10-15 minutes.
Or to chuck your money into the bucket if you've just arrived.
As an egg. Then the old song. Just the TV mute flickering in the corner of the kitchen. Lonely night in spring, tales of old shipping forecasts, occasional rain. I'm scared that when I lose my sight, I'll lose my memories too. It's irrational. Or I'll have nothing but memory to live in, a haunted house full of ghosts and no one living to remember. Then the screen goes white, you are dreaming.
Been lovers. We walked in the blue ballroom, a masked dance of faces without faces and figures without form. The chandelier is made of red, sparrows and ravens. When the music stops, we lose each other, and you don't remember me. Remember these words, apart we are together. Then you would remember everything, and the day would be night, and the night would be day. The masks lift from our eyes, and rise as blackbirds into the sky. The eyes of a blackbird. A dog yelps, chases in a tight circle, the flailing thing. Chase and flail. The jaws champ, growl and banter, bark, tramp and jump, jump and bite. Remember me. I will carry you. The waters will bear you to sleep. If you could only remember the words when you wake up from the dream. Apart, we are together. Our faces were unknown. We met, but not. Dreaming, a sky, a raven at nightfall. In the first of the dream, you will dream of me, but we will never meet. Each morning you will wake. I will have gone from you, and you from me. Apart, we are together. The lightning blast and the world off its blood axis, begging, hungry for a dream. Together in the dream we are apart, apart we are together. Remember these words.
Lilies, the flowers. flowers of sorrow, she said, long ago. And today, lilies. My father and grandfather died blind, and both for a time lived blind. Grandad was a poacher turned gamekeeper, literally. He used to hunt on Croydon Common and make rook pie. No one makes rook pie anymore, do they? Said my grandmother. I've never heard of rook pie before or since. My father's funeral. The night before they slapped his body down to dust. Radio static crackling, my mother singing to herself nearby. Two black horses leading the hearse to the house of the dead. My poor father and his emerald knife scratching and squinting his eyes away, chipping away into the night for pennies. Sometimes the money wouldn't come. He wasn't the sort to question things. Gleaming white plates, a bit of gravy, roast and duck fat, the slave and the bones and chains. Il Pape. Not Pope, is what we used to call him, Il Pape. The father in flower of a Tuscan vine. At least it wasn't Il Duce, Dad. The dome of your head, richly tanned. It looked more boiled. A kipper pumped with hot Neapolitan air and microwave. Squinted away his eyes, those bulging apple johns on summer stalks. Winter hospital glass, the breath condensing. I traced my face with his pinky. One of my first memories of the whiteness of the wild as the snow fell at the end of a cold decade. They buried the deaths and lots filled every bed, holes in the light, blank spots, blank stoppages. Every patch and face blurring and peeling into smoke. The Drake's lantern, cold sympathy served as warmed through remains of a wastrel day. A terminus, bus light, trapped agents. The clock stopped at 12:09, the moment at which it is said he died. Maybe the two men are actually ghosts in the graveyard. The gravestone looks white when you break it open, like coconut eyes. What I haven't said that I wanted to say, Dad wanted to say, said he should have written a book. But where was the book under the pram wheels, the paycheck and rent demands? So where was the book? He lived as he lived, and he died blind. Gave away his time, and in time he gave away his health, his body falling apart as the mind crumbled, the body follows. When I'm old, before I die, the colour will flood back into my eyes, and the skies will fill up with tears, raining back his colours to brighten my day.
Things you can't see. The rock shook, and the mouse swallowed the mountain. The mountain gives birth to the mouse. An unseen promise, promise of promise. It's not the silence of your blindness. River of ghosts, white lanterns printed on the wind. One day I woke and you were still there, lying beside me. I kissed you lightly so as not to wake you.
I remember this one. She served me a shot glass of carrot soup and I pretended it was delicious. We went into a salty back room and did monkey impressions together, and I licked the sweat off the back of her shoulders. Sperm bank alley, your wishbone noose and red flashes, this machine charges. Sleep without dreams, night without stars. Darling, come back to me. I walked home in the rain past what's her name. And why did I never ask? She's there in a blanket with a tin cup for money, smoking a roller. She says with her hands, like hailing a cab to nowhere, no man is a traffic island. Her laugh, like a magnet, to a magnet. The city's cancer. This in the light of lost things, the list of never agains, never another's. I get a cab to the edge of the city and ride in obnoxious frippery one last time. In the morning, a wine glass full of rainwater. The list of things I'll miss seeing when I can't see. Drop where a conker cleaves beneath my boot an old yellow tennis ball. Kicked at the pricks with their selfie sticks, the white peel of the rock drill burrowing into the hard ground of Hoxton tea lights. That bloody squealing, the screeching opera harpy, heavy machinery creeching, mechanical lurch of an Anglican approach, a jumped cavity. So much, the licks punch in the morning, the dread thumb, thump, me, Richard, then. A tin can clatters down the steps, it hits the tracks and becomes a train. Setting, but it feels like 4 a.m. The list of things I'll miss seeing when I can't see. The puddle I jump into and the splash it makes 20 years before. How perfect to live in this moment at dusk with the light fading. I'm trying to make myself sad. make myself the saddest I can be, the saddest anyone has ever been. So sad that when finally I rise panting from the plunge, starved for breath and gasping, when the sadness breaks all over me and splashes back into itself in blue, I'll be less sad, even happy. Sad, happy, or happy, sad. I will stare into my life and make myself the saddest I can ever be, because finally, when I am the saddest anyone has ever been, I will be happy. Black blindness. I don't see black, but live a miasma of colour, yellow, blue, green. I see not red, not black. It's like swimming in a pool.
I dreamt you were dying. I dreamt you died alone at night, without me, and I was a ghost beside you. Absent and there, and you cried out, but I wasn't there. Then I dreamt you were dying in a bed below me, and my love couldn't save you. I did nothing, didn't help, watched. Helped your skin as the sickness emptied itself out. The violence of the choked air rocked by screaming. The shaking apart of the soul in anguish. Molt of angel wing, flake and fleck of bile, blood. I did nothing. You held me then in the morning, but I couldn't tell you. And dreams are real. I dreamt in the dream you had died. You were blind and passed at night from the unseen to unseen shades. Blindness is a truer kind of vision as we pass into the unseen. The sleepwalker at the edge of the cliff leaps out of the dream.
Dreams of falling blossoms. I wake clutching a flower. It reminds me of something I can't remember, but I know I've forgotten. If I could not touch it, it would come back to me. Outside in that weird light, the last whistle of the guard, the season snapped and it seems later than it is. Everyone's knocked off early. They turned off the lights. Those 50s bright song brutalism halls, halls and halls and halls. Maybe I have dementia. Ah, bruised my knee. Crack, it caught on the corner. More bloody painful than the old, you know, sight thing. The slowness of the end. How the spine seems like a cross on which to hang flesh. I will drop you like an egg, she said. You did, I said. Just the TV. Mute flickering in the corner of the kitchen. The sun is only setting, but it feels like 4 a.m. Pain! That pain! Pain of loss, pain of losing, pain of this, pain of choosing. Pain of drawing the moon down and burning up its flameless charred remnant char and smoking petrol. Pain of these eyes, fading eyes, the world dissolving into grey and blue lights, a flood and cloud of shimmering snail tracks and spider dances. The photograph is blurring like film caught in a projector tearing into flame. Black and yellow, the image of you in my mind is burning away, resolving into flames, into ashes, into night and nothing. Pain of these joints, chrome holes, rusty, brown scars and tight spasms, bend and warm. Pain of you, I never meant to face. Pain of the sunset when the paint is picked off. Pain of the dream that flies at morning. I open my eyes into the remnant of their life and stare back at myself, blank, finished, forgotten. I am hollow. What remains of a man when what makes him has collapsed? A shrunken thing, a beast, a ghost, sightless and sorry. What is there left to want? The ostrich flew. Rook pie. My head hurts. My eyes, blood pressure, bad stories and failed resolutions. There's nothing inside me but broken organs playing wrong notes and forgotten tunes, tunelessly, voicelessly, in resounding silence, as if nothing were not beautiful, as if empty as fullness, as full as emptiness. Pain of the late breath, grasp and hand. Pain of the wine's last third, I can't finish, I'm too weak to drink. Pain of the empty table stretching in front of me as I drink alone. Loss, desire, despair. Pain of that autumn morning, white with winter snow. Pain of... pain and waste. Waste of...
Midnight tastes like a kiss without lips. You were sleeping. Do you remember our wedding when we married in moonlight? Tender me, laid as carved in lies on a cold slab of stone, shaken awake and peeling off skin, finger by finger, pretty white fingers from my throat. Only love can end these tears. Only death can open these eyes, only blind. These fragments and movements will perish and fly from us and become what never was. Our love is not like love. Remember, we met in the dream. Two souls, unlike in ways, the fracture of one mirror. We shared our souls. What is the soul if not desire? You are my soul. What else could that be? Form the words. Form the words at the apex of the palate. Say the words, please. The sleep still crumbling quickly in your eyes before you remember you are yourself. Before you open your eyes to whatever's left. Remember the words. Say them. Say eternity. Say together. Say apart we are together. And we will never be apart. But when you wake, I know you won't remember.
Radio static crackling, my mother singing to herself nearby. Alone. Utterly alone. I'm scared that when I lose my sight, I'll lose my memories, too. It's irrational. Or I'll have nothing but memory to live in, a haunted house full of ghosts and no one living to remember. The fable of the man who remembered. The man who couldn't forget. Skating on Lake Empty. The darkness is coming in. The dark is inside. Funny memory. The torturer and the laughing blade hacking away in the happy evenings, twisting the screw blade of black night space, staring blankly, blankly into bleach black despair, death with your fingertips, but denied that mercy. Haunting the ghosts, the last guest, hotel amnesia, memory palace, the deposed king haunting the ghosts. The house has grown cold, and soon there will be no one left to give ghosts to haunt. I spent years trying to write a musical setting of Shakespeare's sonnet 116. My grandmother had recited it to me when she was going blind. I could never finish the music. I started to believe that if I ever finished the setting, she would die. So I didn't. She died, very alone, and very scared, and I never finished the music. I guess I never will. It isn't black blindness. I don't see black. But I live in a miasma of color. Yellow, blue, green, I see it. Not red, not black. It's like swimming in a dream.
I will carry you. The waters will bear you to sleep. Two worlds in time. You are divine. You will move into and become the night and embrace that dark world in your depths. You will bridle the moon and ride on the stars away into peace. The peacefulness of last things, the silence that ends the sentence. I'm standing on the edge of you, ready to dive with you into you. You are not mind. Without sight, we see the whatness of things. Trembling, the terror of the real, where the lights blaze and the words at the tip of the tongue, and the end of every judgment, the night's judgment. Moths flit and dazzle. Life is short, and art so long to learn. Lover stands, then it slips away. My love is death to you. My love for you is death. It will choke and smother you, wrap you and leech the air from your lungs and the love from your heart. And I will hold you like a doll and you will be mine. Your love establishes the death in me, the life and death in things, the wreck of all, the shame and hope in ending and beginning. In the light sparkle, I dreamt I held you.
Ah, Father, in heaven.
Please, don't lose the best thing that's inside you. Don't give away the biggest thing that drives you. The sleepwalker, on the edge of the cliff, leaps out of the dream.
Okay.